In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Dear audience, this is Language and Linguistics Online. I am Dr. Khurram Shahzad from National University of Modern Languages, Islamabad. Today, I intend to talk about the origin of language. In this series of lectures, I will be making use of The Study of Language by George Yule. In the very first chapter, George Yule talks about the origin of language, and he says that there is no definitive answer for this question, because so many people have given different kinds of theories, and these theories, they are based on their conjecture, on their guess. That is why he says that there is no definitive answer. The first source that George Yule talks about is known as the divine source. George Yule, being a non-Muslim author, talks about biblical, books, Genesis, and brings some other references from some other sources. But I will be talking about that in the Holy Quran, Allah Almighty has said, when Allah Almighty was talking about the story of Adam and Eve, that Allah Almighty has given us the language. For example, in chapter number 2, Surah Baqarah, verse 31, Allah Almighty says, and I translate, He taught Adam all the names of things, and He bestowed them to the angels and asked, Tell me the names of these, and if you truly think, you can. So of course, this is a kind of dialogue between Allah Almighty and the angels, and Allah Almighty is telling us that language is a divine object. So we, being Muslims, we believe that Allah Almighty has bestowed the human beings with the language. And since Holy Quran is one of the books of Allah Almighty revealed upon the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we believe that this book contains only truth in it. While discussing different examples, George Yule has also mentioned one of the examples of King Akbar, and he is in surprise when he is talking about Akbar, because the kind of result that this experiment has given us today, science also talks about this experiment. So this shows that George Yule also makes use of politics when he is making use of references from different kinds of sources. The second kind of theory that George Yule talks about, and this theory is known as the bow wow theory. In this scenario, often different objects flew by making a coco or cuckoo sound. So of course, he is making a reference to different kinds of birds. So as birds, they are making different kinds of sounds. Human beings, when they heard those sounds, so he says that this theory is known as bow wow theory, saying that maybe human beings, they have got the language from these different primates. Of course, it is a kind of conjecture. It is a kind of guess. He is not himself 100% sure about it. In English, in addition to cuckoo, we have got splash, bang, boom, rattle, buzz, hiss, screech, and of course, bow wow. Words that sound similar to the noises that describe are examples of onomatopoeia. So one of the theories is coming from bow wow theory. The next theory that George Yule discusses is known as poo-poo theory. Another of Jesperson's nickname was the poo-poo theory, which proposed that speech developed from the instinctive sounds of people make in emotional circumstances. Though by describing this theory, he himself negates this theory, saying that human beings, they do not utter those sounds when they are not emotional the way these sounds are uttered. So he rejects this theory himself. The third source he makes use of is known as the musical source. Part of the problem with the discussion of natural sounds is the assumption that they were used to create words. However, before we utter words, we can produce a wide range of sounds that aren't word forms at all. Let's go back to the observation that human infants can possess sounds early on and then soon begin to produce sounds in a way that may provide some clues to how language developed. But again, he feels that the kind of knowledge that he has discussed in this theory, it is not coming up to the evidence that science can provide us. So again, he rejects this theory as well. And he moves on to discuss that human beings, they have got mouth, lips, tongue, vocal cords, and all of them, they help us to produce sounds. And the other animals or primates, they do not have this same kind of developed system. So he is talking about that language, particularly the spoken language, maybe it was developed 1,100 years ago or 500,000 years ago. And the written expressions came into being, so far as science is concerned, 500,000 before. And resultantly, all these guesses that he is making, he comes to the conclusion that we do not have sufficient evidence to say that they are the right kind of theories. Another kind of theory that he talks about is known as social interactionism. In social interactionism, he talks about human beings, they like to stay in groups. They like to talk in groups because they were always in danger. So the kind of evidence that he has got on the basis of this, he makes this conclusion that human beings, they must have been living together in the form of groups. So they had to talk. And because they are social animals, while they were interacting with each other, language was developed. Lastly, he is talking about the physical adaptation source. In physical adaptation source, he is talking about the, you know, structure of the face, of the mouth, of the lips and tongue, and he is talking about how they help us to produce sounds. Our teeth are different from animals. Our teeth are there to help us produce sounds like fa, va. So these two sounds are produced with the help of interaction between the lips and the, you know, teeth. And in this way, these sounds are produced in English or in some other languages of the world. So vocal cords, sometimes they create obstruction and the sound is stopped, and then different kinds of sounds are produced. And our nose, it also helps us to produce different kinds of sounds. Then he talks about, you know, pharynx and larynx, and in phonetics and phonology chapter, I should talk about them in detail. So you can see that he has talked about teeth and lips, mouth and tongue, larynx and pharynx. Lastly, he talks about the human brain and the kind of, you know, genetics we have got. We being Muslims believe that Allah Almighty has bestowed us all these things. And brain is another kind of, you know, element that Allah Almighty has bestowed us with. So we make use of brain and we think language, we produce language, we try to break down the kind of, you know, language that we are receiving through our ears with the help of different kinds of sounds. So in our brain, which is working like a computer, it breaks down all these sounds and we make use of those sounds, we understand them, and then we encode the message, then we produce the message. And this message is produced, of course, with the help of larynx, pharynx, lips, teeth and vocal cords. So in this chapter, George Yule has talked about all these resources, and he says that this is how the human beings, they have produced the language, or this is the origin of the language. Thank you very much.